The topic is basically number one. Well, you know, I've known you for a little bit, right? We met last semester. We talked about different things over time. And what do you think about SOS, right? You're at the very conception of it, in a way, right? You were the treasurer.
The treasurer of the organization with no money.
With no money.
Right. It's been the
and OJ was the president, and he
still
disappeared.
Is, apparently.
Yeah, well, we're non-presidential, non-hierarchical, non-institutional organization by now.
We're kind of
anarchy in action.
Not as douchey.
Right.
As the real anarchist.
Right, there you go. So, I know you were at the very beginning. I mean, seriously speaking, you know, we went to the open mic at Collingwood Arts Center, right, which we did for the whole semester, even though you couldn't make it because of your job, you know, schedule conflict. And you kind of opened up the huge bang, right? You read from Murakami Ryu's...
In the Miso Soup.
Exactly, in the Miso Soup, right? The most graphic, explicit passage you could find. So, and I saw you kind of briefly on and off, you know, in between places and class, outside of class. What's your feeling about SOS? You know, as someone who was there at the beginning, but who was absent for most of the time, except, I mean, on those occasions I mentioned, and also the first acting workshop, where you did read Samuel Beckett, or Brandon, right?
Yeah, I remember that.
Ohio Impromptu.
What do I think of SOS?
Yeah, did it accomplish what you thought it was going to accomplish? We talked a lot about it.
Well, yeah, that was the thing, that the goals of SOS were really vague from the start. And I think if each person accomplished what they wanted to accomplish individually, then the organization as a whole accomplished something.
Right.
I don't know if we were trying to do anything revolutionary or even reformatory, or even, you know, even trying to claim that, you know, art is dead and we're trying to revive it, whatever. But I think we were just trying to make our own individualistic expressions. And I think it, you know, if each person was able to do something, to contribute something, then it served its purpose. I think it was to try and get everybody together, brainstorm, essentially.
Mm. What was the purpose for you?
The purpose for me? I think it was, for me, more like trying to broaden my horizons, broaden my scope or not necessarily knowledge, but my awareness of various authors.
Mm.
Some authors I'd never heard of before, like Samuel Beckett, I'd never heard of him before. The Acting Workshop is just one example. And then also sharing our passions, sharing, you know, your passion for Henry Miller or my passion for Murakami Haruki, and just showing that energy.
Mm.
That was my goal, was mm-hmm. to try and share my own energy while also being able to enjoy and share in the energy of others.
Was it successful in doing this?
I think so.
You think so?
Yeah. I mean, it was successful for me.
Mm.
It may not have been successful for someone else. They might not have gotten what they wanted out of it. But if that's the case, then you might ask, well, did SOS serve its function? Well, it did to those people that it was successful for. It didn't for others. And is that SOS's fault? Maybe it is. Maybe we didn't cater to everyone's needs. Maybe we didn't do enough Buto. maybe we did too much poetry. Not enough of this, you know, not enough painting. But, you know, like I said, it's all about sharing each other's passions. And so the people that wanted to do those things that didn't get covered should step up next time and say, listen, let's do this. And they got to start their own little thing, like Joe was doing with the manga workshop, which I guess fell through, I don't know. But yeah, I mean, that's a step in the right direction, I think. Having individuals create their own little projects
mm-hmm.
to try and share their passions, get other people interested in what they're doing, and then maybe generate some new ideas about their own work. So maybe that's a way that we can improve, is make more of those like mini type sessions
mm.
for things that would interest certain people.
That's easy for you to say because you're going to be in Japan.
Exactly. It's very easy for me to say.
No, I guess what I'm asking is, you know, a lot of times when you start something, it goes in directions that's kind of unpredictable, right? Unexpected. For example, simple fact, like when I got to know you, you know, your schedule, work schedule was not yet gelled. So I figured you were going to be a very integral part of it. Definitely OJ, you know, when you sign up somebody to be a president and treasurer. And I thought very seriously that we're going to be a formal organization, right?
Right.
In part because of Satomi's suggestion and really a push. Right. So I wrote up a constitution. We sent out an application, which never got responded. We never got a response for it. So, you know, what happened afterwards, right? Weekly acting workshop, open mics, they kind of became something that we didn't really expect, you know? I mean, we talked about it. Remember, we had a conversation about the underworld. We might want to create some kind of a, you know, illegal, secret underbelly of the SOS. And speaking of which, do you want to, you know, this thing that you did in my office, maybe near the beginning of the semester, about Matt's haiku? You want to make that into a, like, a generally available to everybody for viewing?
I mean, we could. Yeah. We certainly could. I mean, I think it's hilarious. Matt thinks it's hilarious.
You have no objection to it?
No, no, no.
Let's ask Matt and put it on.
But let's ask him first,
right? Yeah, of course.
But, I mean, in fact, just before school let out, he was making them. He was creating more of them. And showing us.
He was, or were you creating as
no,
him?
No, he really was.
Okay. Like
around the... We were just hanging out, and, like, I think maybe Brian made one up.
Yeah.
And then Matt made one up and said, there, I can do it better, or something. So I think Matt gets a kick out of it, too. It gives him attention.
Right, right.
But, yeah, I don't have any objection to putting it public.
I thought it was quite funny, too. But
some are funnier than others, but...
Yeah.
And then others are kind of like really inside. You gotta just gotta know who Matt is, really.
Yeah.
So maybe getting his real work out there will make the haiku all the more hilarious.
You mean the real work that he's been reading every week at the open mic?
Right, right. That stuff.
Yeah.
That stuff.
What do you think of his fiction? Matt's fiction?
Like the inspector or whatever?
I listen to him, do my best, but I really cannot keep track. I think he's doing something about the Antarctica, Nazi doctor,
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I know he gets a lot of his inspiration from comics, though.
Yeah.
That's all I really know. Yeah. And I've read them, and they seem to be, you know, they're Matt. They're Matt.
What does that mean?
I don't know what that means. You just gotta know Matt. I mean, it means something to me, but I can't really describe that. I mean, Matt, he's, like, he's not really a video game nerd.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he'll play them, or he prefers to watch. He's just a comic book guy, I guess. Like, his works are pretty much comic books in word. I mean, that's what he wants to end up doing anyway, is writing script for comics. Because he doesn't think he can draw, so... I mean, he does doodles and stuff, but he's told me himself that he's not serious about, like, becoming an artist. He wants to become a story writer for these comics. And maybe that's what he's doing with this Antarctica thing.
Yeah.
He's practicing for that. So, I don't know. It's Matt.